much looking forward now to the Connacht final at this stage. I presume Galway, confidence high, great run in the league. Up until the latter stages, no, maybe a little bit disappointed about how it ended, but at the same time, all goes well for maybe an extended run in the Championship.
Yeah, look, we had a good run in the league. We set out at the start of the year to take it game by game. Getting to the league final was a huge bonus. Unfortunately, it didn't go well for us on the day. Maybe in the last couple of minutes, we kind of ran Cork close, but when you're playing the top teams, you kind of have to have your performance on the field 110%, and we missed a few scoring chances. But look, that's put to bed now. We've learnt our lessons, and we've reviewed where we went wrong. That's league. The next couple of weeks now, it's important to put the head down, and the Championship is just around the corner. So we're looking forward to it.
How significant is it, and how much of a boost is it for the development of the team to have been involved in high-profile games against the Corks of this world, against the Dublins of this world over the last year or so?
Look, sure, it kind of tells you where you are really when you're playing the likes of the Corks and Dublins. Like, they are the standard bearers for Cork the last 10 years, and I know Dublin have, you know, the last two All-Irelands. But like, it's great to get such competitive games, and if you can match them and match their intensity, it gives you an indication of where you're at. And, you know, getting them games, it's as good as two training sessions, really. And, you know, you know where your players are at and how your players are performing against the big games, against the big teams.
When it comes to judging the age-old rivalry that's there between Galway and Mayo, you could look back to the Connacht final last year, very close game. But since then, it seems that Galway have stolen a little bit of a march. Convincing win in the latter stages of the Championship last year, a win over Mayo in the league this time round. So is complacency something I presume that you'd be guarding against? It shouldn't really be a factor.
No, we're not even. We're just taking one game. Like, we're Mayo and Galway are your age-old rivals. We're setting up for a cracker of a Connacht final. We're under no illusions. The game that Mayo are going to throw at us, or the fight that Mayo are going to throw at us, and, you know, we give them every bit of, they deserve every bit of respect, and we'll give them the respect. And you know, we're under no illusions of the battle that lies ahead on June the 23rd.
Very strong Galway representation in the team of the league.
Yes,
for Division 1.
Yes, with four girls on the team of the league, it was a great boost, and it's great for Galway ladies football to have four girls represented on the team of the league.
And a new management set up in 2019. The transition seems to have been smooth.
Yes, look, Tim was involved as a selector last year. Stephen was a huge loss last year, but we stuck with Tim. Tim stepped up to manager, and it was important to get that smooth transition as well. Do you know, that girls knew what we were about, and it has worked so far, and you know, we're working well as a whole unit, management and players, and we're getting on well, and you know, we're learning off one another the whole time.
And finally, everybody will be looking towards the business end of the Championship. But for the moment, all the attention is very much
June
on the Connacht final.
June the 23rd, we're not looking, not even into August, July. The 23rd of June is etched in our minds for the next 2 weeks, and we're going to go out and give it one hell of a battle. And please God, things will go well on the day for us.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you.